Hello children, good morning. Welcome for today's biology class. So today we are going to continue the chapter Animal Kingdom. So the topics going to be covered are phylum Platyhelminthes, Aschelminthes and Annelida. So first let us study regarding Platyhelminthes. This Platyhelminthes are dorso-ventrally flattened body structure having organisms. So dorso ventrally flattened means what? Dorsal side is the upper side and ventral side is the lower side. It has been flattened. So that's why flat worm. So mostly these all are endoparasites. They live inside, no? The human being, otherwise other animals. So that's why you call that as endoparasites. So these all are bilaterally symmetrical. Means by means of a cutting, so we can divide into right and left equal halves, bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic. So three layers, ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm, three layers are there, acoelomate, no coelom, and they show organ level of organization. So here three examples have been given, planaria, liver fluke and tapeworm. So they have hooks and suckers in parasitic worms. So because it has to be attached to the intestine, otherwise they will be sent out by the intestine movements. So that's why hooks and suckers are present to, it has to, you know, get attached to the intestine. For that purpose they have. And they have a special type of cells called flame cells. It is helpful for osmoregulation and excretion. So here sexes are not separate. Fertilization is internal and the development is through larval stages. So planaria, you studied in 10th also, they show high regeneration capacity. If we get planaria into three portion also, the upper portion, head portion can develop the tail, the middle portion can develop both head and the tail, and the tail portion can develop the head. Okay, like that the planaria, it shows high regeneration capacity. So here no, this is planaria. So next one example are tinea, tapeworm, fasciola, that is liver fluke. Aschelminthes. So here the you can call that as round worm because body is circular. So previous one the body it was dorso ventrally flattened, so flat worm. This one can be called known as round worm. So they may be free living, aquatic or terrestrial or parasitic in plants and animals. So these organisms know they show organ system level of classification and the symmetry is bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and pseudo coelomate, false coelom. Alimentary canal is complete and within that know they develop the, they have a muscular pharynx also. So the excretory tube know it removes the waste from the body through out, no, they can send out by means of excretory pore. Sexes are separate, dioecious organisms, so females are longer than males. Fertilization is internal and the development it can be direct or indirect. Larval form may be there or may not be there. Example, it is Ascaris and Eucheria, that is no elephant diasis causing worms, that is filarial worm and hook worm are coming under this category. Next one, Annelida. So Annelida, no, it can be aquatic, it can be marine or freshwater, it can be terrestrial also. They are free living or parasite. They exhibit organ system level of organization and the symmetry is bilaterally symmetrical and triploblastic organisms. They show three layers and the segmentation is metamerically segmented and they possess no coelom, that's why we call that a coelomate, and presence of longitudinal and circular muscles are there. It is no helpful for locomotion of earthworm. Hope you must have observed how the earthworm is moving, no? Not only earthworm, most of the annelids, no, all of them, they have this type of muscles. So like that, no, by contraction and relaxation the earthworm, no, they can move. So here earthworm and this is neris, okay, and this is no leech. Aquatic animals, that is aquatic annelids like neris, no, they possess lateral appendages called parapodia. Can you see here the lateral appendages like parapodia is present in neris and all. It is helpful in swimming. The circulatory system is closed and the excretory organ is no nephridia. Nephrida is the excretory organ with help of that They can do excretion and osmoregulation. And the neural system, it consists of ganglia. Ganglia means group of nerve cells present. And the nerve cord also there. Okay, nerve cord, that is dorsal and ventral. Mainly, no, the ventral cord, the nerve cord, no. This double ventral nerve cord is there. And the nearest, it is dioecious. But the earthworm and leeches, they are monoecious. Okay, so reproduction is sexual reproduction. Example, nereus, earthworm, blood sucking leech. Okay, so all are coming under this category.